All you folks out there on YouTube, please let me know if you can hear what I'm saying right now. Somebody make a comment. I'm doing a sound check. Last week I had some real problems with sound, but I think they have it under control now. So please let me know if you can hear me. Hey, those of you out there on Facebook, I'm going to start answering a few questions from Facebook before we start out the workout here. So if you have questions, go ahead and post them to my Facebook wall. I'm a little worried here. The audio is horrible. I'm not sure what I can do. I have the best microphone that I could find. It's actually a pretty good microphone.
This is about how close I can use the microphone during the workout. How clearly can you hear me? There's some kind of background noise.
So, how's the audio now? Okay, it's interesting. Some people say they can hear nothing, and some people say they hear a vacuum. I guess that's my disguise, but you know what? I can't turn those off. Anyway, let me answer some questions here from people on Facebook. I wanted to make sure everyone can see the video. I can see it on my website. Just wanted to make sure the rest of you can. Everything seems to be working well. Okay, let's start with some questions from Goron. What do you think about vegan diet? Well, I think a vegan diet is very healthy. I think that it probably would reduce your chance of getting a lot of heart disease and other problems. Probably also reduces your chance of cancer also. However, being a vegan bodybuilder is really difficult. You will not get the same muscular gains, in my opinion, as your vegetarian friends or your meat friends. So, you know, you can be a vegan bodybuilder, but it's tough. You have to be a complete expert on nutrition. You need to know what amino acids are in every food you're eating, how to blend them. So that's what I think about vegan diet. Okay, let's pull another question off Facebook here. Justin says the audio is bad. Can you people describe, I can remember people saying it was a disturbing noise. There was a crackling chair. Oh, wait, I think I see something on there. It's making noise like the music was quiet. Okay, tell me, man, does it sound better now? It's the diatribe. Let me answer some more questions for you guys. Tell me what you think of the audio here. Let's see. Lewis on Facebook, stop spamming me. I've got like 6 questions, comments about the audio. A lot of people seem to be getting the audio wrong. Let's see. Jesse on Facebook is asking, how late is too late to work out in the evening or night? Is it okay to work late or skip workout that time of day? Well, let me answer this one. The best time to work out is when you can work out. A workout at a bad time is... Here's what I would say. A good workout in a bad time is better than a bad workout in a good time. It's not optimal to work out in the evening right before bed. Because your energy level is down, not only that because it will interfere with your sleep, but doing a workout before bed is better than no workout at all. So that's what I'd say about doing the workout. Now, hold on, I need to check out the sound. Let's take a look. How many of you can hear me? If you can hear me fine, please post, because there's a number of people that are saying they can't hear me at all, and I don't know what's going on. Okay, people, don't freak out. I'm going to shut off the picture a second here to check out the sound. So don't freak out. You're going to lose the image for a couple of minutes here. I'll be back, okay? Hold tight. Okay, that should be better. I'm glad you people commented about the sound because I had the wrong microphone being used. I was running all over town last night looking for a microphone. It'd be a shame if I was using the stupid internal microphone instead of this
nice microphone I ran all over town. So please let me know if is the sound better now. It should be much, much better. Okay. Thank you, people, for being persistent. I'm glad I started this beforehand to make sure the sound is fine, because the workout would be kind of tough to do if you couldn't hear me. Okay, we got that under control. Okay, I'm going to answer a few more questions from Facebook. By the way, if you haven't had your coffee and you plan on having it, go ahead, and you should have had it 45 minutes ago, but better late than never. And also, you should have been hydrated a long time ago, but if you're not, drink that water now. If you look off to the edge, well, let's see if I can do this. Where's it? If you look real carefully off to the left of the clock, you can see my liter stein of water. I'm chugging the water right here, so you should be chugging water too. Okay, I'm gonna answer a few more questions on Facebook, and then I have to get my butt ready here. Okay, Sebastian is asking about skin stretch, the stretch marks. I am not an expert on stretch marks. That is really a medical issue, but let me tell you a few things about stretch marks. A lot of people get stretch marks naturally. In interesting places. Some people get them on their quads. Some people get them in the small of their back. You know, I'm not sure there's anything you can do about that. There's a lot of home remedies. I'm not convinced they work. It's something you need to see a dermatologist about. However, there are a number of stretch marks that are indicative of steroid use, because what happens, people's muscles grow so fast that the skin can't keep up. Very common stretch marks that steroid users get are between the line between the pec and the shoulder. That's a very common place for steroid users to get stretch marks. As again, I'm not sure what you can do about it, other than what they do in bodybuilding contests, which is, you know, cover yourself with this black gooey ink and make yourself so dark that it hides all the stretch marks. Okay, sorry, that wasn't a very useful answer, because I don't know what I'm talking about. Let's see. I'm looking on Facebook to answer a few more questions here. Evan asked, do you have any tips for proper posture when using an exercise bike for cardio? Yes, not so much posture. It doesn't matter too much what you do from the waist up. However, the seat height is very important for your knee safety. Most people who ride a bike put the seat way, way too low, and it's really difficult on your knee. You don't want the seat so high that your hips wobble from side to side, or so high that you have to move your ankle up and down to reach the pedal. The way I set the seat height, so I set the extend both legs straight and make it so that when your heels are on top of the pedal, your knees are just slightly bent. That's about the right height for me. And then when you're pedaling, focus on keeping your foot horizontal to the ground. Don't pump the pedals with your calves, because that can give you overuse injuries with your Achilles. So yeah, mainly just make sure the seat height is high enough. Okay. Thomas on Facebook is asking, what protein powder do you use nowadays? Oh, good question. Here's the problem. There's a number of organic protein powders that are best. They're really the only ones I like. The problem is that they're really expensive, and honestly, I cannot afford it. They're like four times as much as anything else or more. So as much as I hate the stevia, I still use the Optimum Nutrition 100% natural protein powder. As I say, I don't like the fact that they have the artificial sweetener in them, because whey really does not need artificial sweeteners or flavors. It's fine by itself. It's got a great neutral flavor. I love the organic stuff that you can just mix, but you know, honestly, I can't afford it. If you can, it's awesome, because it's better for you, and okay. Jordy on Facebook says, don't forget to pillow screen for us. You know, I guess I have a pillow available. I guess I could. But no, this is a positive workout. We're not going to pillow screen. Oh, by the way, so I'm only going to answer questions on Facebook for a few more minutes, and then I'm going to switch over to YouTube and answer questions there for the rest of the day. Okay, let me refresh my page here on Facebook. Okay, here's a question. Have you heard of Animal Pack, the vitamins, and what do you think of their multivitamins? Well, I can tell you just by the name that I hate it. Animal Pack, they make it sound like it's supposed to give you some animal-like sort of energy boost. No, I really hate vitamins. The reason is that when people take vitamins, it gives them an excuse to have a horrible diet. It's like, you know, oh, I have my vitamin pill. I don't need to eat vegetables today. As far as I'm concerned, when it's not completely been proven that the vitamins in a vitamin pill are as effective as the vitamins in vegetables. If you want the best vitamins, you've got to eat your vegetables. And I don't like the idea of relying on a pill for that. So I'd much rather see you chug a lot of fresh vegetables than eat any vitamin pill, especially one called Animal Pack. Okay, I'm looking here on Facebook for... Okay, this is going to be the last question on Facebook. Then I need to change my clothes and get ready for the workout, go to the bathroom, finish drinking my water. Okay. Georgie on Facebook asks, what do you think about creatine? Well, there's very few supplements that I think have proven to be effective. Very, very few. I think creatine is one of the few that has been shown to be marginally helpful. If you go to my website on supplements, you'll see that caffeine and creatine are two things that I do say are okay. The problem is, and this is a problem with all supplements, they are not regulated. There is no safety testing whatsoever. And all the time, you'll see this in the news, some supplement maker or another has to recall their product because there's toxic metals in it, and people's livers have been destroyed or people die. So if you're going to use a creatine, find one that has been safety tested by an independent lab, like USP, or there's a number of other organizations, independent organizations that certify the safety by doing batch testing of supplements. So if you're going to use a supplement, just make sure it's not going to kill you. It's the gains from creatine or anything else are so minor, it is not worth killing yourself just for those minor gains. Okay, that's the last question. There's 5 minutes left before the workout starts, so I need to get my butt ready. Get your workout clothes on, get your dumbbells out, and let's get ready to have an awesome workout. Okie doke. See you in a bit.
Thank you. Hey folks, I'm just getting ready here. Hold on. Just getting things set up. Okay, let's see. Okay, 10 a.m. Welcome to my live chest workout. Today we're going to do an hour-long chest workout. We're going to be doing about 10 minutes of warm-up first, and then we're going to do a maybe 40, 50, 60-minute workout. We'll see how it goes. This is for all ability levels. It's mainly for intermediate and advanced, but for you beginning people, I'll give you variations you can do. So this is for everybody. Again, I'd like to thank everyone for your patience. I screwed up last weekend. It was not YouTube. The reason you couldn't see it is because I didn't push the start button. I screwed up. Okay, I'm sorry. I know it's working now. The sound is working, so we're set. Before we get going here, just a quick announcement. The same start time tomorrow, we're going to do a back workout. You will need a pull-up bar for this, so please join me for my live back workout tomorrow, too. Okay, let's get started with a warm-up, and then we can yammer some more. I'm going to go ahead and start doing some push-ups to warm up. We're going to do, starting with a knee push-up. So, on your knees, just do a nice set of knee push-ups to warm up. And after that, we're going to do a set of dumbbell flies to warm up. The weight to use for your warm-up is about 50% of what you would use when you're doing 8 reps. Now, a lot of people ask, you know, don't you stretch to warm up? And I think stretching is a horrible way to warm up. Stretching is a great thing to do, but do it in yoga class. Don't do it as a warm up. Okay, now I'm going to do my flies at 50% of my weight. Now, we'll talk about form later, so you beginners who don't quite know what's going on, don't worry. I'll give you some form pointers here. So, we are going to spend another 8 minutes or so warming up. It's important you warm up because you don't want to get injured when you start lifting heavy. Now, a lot of people ask, too, what about jogging for warming up? Better than stretching, but as far as I'm concerned, when you're doing heavy lifting, there is nothing that's better for warming up than doing light sets of the exercises you're going to be doing. Okay, let's go back and do our knee push-ups again. Okay, for you beginners, make sure that your torso is straight. Don't point your butt up in the air. Don't let it sag. Keep yourself straight. And your shoulders are held back and down, kind of like you're holding a tennis ball between your shoulder blades. I'll talk about that a lot more later. Okay, we're going to do another warm-up set of flies. And then we're going to move up in the weight. Ugh. Remember, this is a warm-up. Don't kill yourself yet. This should be really easy. Okay, when we're done with this warm-up set, this is 50% of the weight you use at 8 reps. We're going to go ahead, and now we're going to move up to about 80% of the weight that we use for 8 reps. So go ahead and increase the weight on your dumbbells. Sorry. No, that broke your eardrums. Now you'll notice I have these silly encyclopedias here. I actually find it a lot easier to get the weights up into position from having them on a stack of encyclopedias. I know a lot of you make fun of me for that, but that's okay. I don't want to injure myself getting the weights up into position. Okay. Now we got the dumbbell set at about 80% of the weight we're going to use. Now we're going to do a set of real push-ups as a warm-up. Now, beginners out there, you just keep doing the knee push-ups to warm up. In intermediate and advanced, let's do some real push-ups. Okay, now let's do a set of our flies. Remember, we're still warming up here. Shoulders down and back. Thrust your chest up. Okay, we're going to do one more set of warm-ups, then we're going to hit it and get to it. Let me just take a question here from YouTube. Let's see. Whoa, they're scrolling by kind of fast here. Okay, is there a question from YouTube? They're just jealous, too easy. Yeah, it's supposed to be easy. It's a warm-up. Guys, shut the F up. He's 50. It's a warm-up. You can make fun of me when we're doing our full weight. Okay. We're going to do our last warm-up set here, and then we're going to start with the heavy stuff. So let's do a full set of push-ups. By the way, if any of you are just watching instead of following along, shame on you. Get off your butts and work out with me. That's what this is for. It's live. Okay. Last set of flies for warm up. Yeah. Okay. Now let's go ahead and load our dumbbells up with the full weight we're going to use for the flies. You beginners out there, if you're not sure, err on the side of doing it too light. Always better too light than too heavy. And let me describe what we're going to do here. The first thing we're going to do is two sets of flies, heavy, with 3 minutes rest between. And then we're going to do two sets of dumbbell press, heavy, with 3 minutes between. And that's all I'm going to tell you for right now. Because if you knew what I was going to do the rest of the workout, you may not stick around. It gets brutal at the end. Okay, got our weights ready. After this set, I'm going to show you the proper form of the fly. I don't want to waste our time yet. Get our handy dandy timer ready, so we only do 3 minutes between sets. Okay, let's go. Number of reps is not important. Just do as many reps as you can with good form, okay? Okay, we'll start the timer. We get 3 minutes rest, and then we're going to do another set of flies. Now let's talk about the form on flies. You've always heard me say, keep your shoulders down and back. Let me show you what that means here. Okay, so down and back. Thrust your chest forward. There's a couple reasons for that, but let me show you what it looks like. So pretend, this is what I'm talking about with a tennis ball. Pretend you're holding a tennis ball between your shoulder blades like that. So down and back. There's two reasons we're holding our shoulders that way. The first is it makes your shoulder a lot more stable and less likely to be injured. The second and more important reason is it gives you more power. And I'm going to talk about that in an upcoming video. It basically gives you more leverage. It's the easiest way to increase your bench strength, your fly strength, and everything. It's just holding your shoulders down and back. We have a minute or two here. I'm going to answer a few questions from YouTube. he just did 110 pounds on each arm. Actually, no, it's not. I have two 25s on the side, that's 100, and the bar is 5, so these are 105-pound flies. Again, the amount of weight is not important. You do whatever it is that challenges you. People often ask, you know, I do 37 kilos, is that good? How should I know? 37 kilos is good if last week you did 35 kilos. All that's important is you get a little stronger every month. It doesn't really matter how much you lift compared to your workout buddies, as long as the trend is right. Okay, we have 50 seconds here, time for one more question. Why do we start with flies? Great question. A lot of people think that bench is the number one exercise for pecs. I disagree. I say flies, the squeezing type exercises, are more important. So that's why I like starting with them. And also because most people are weaker on the squeezing exercises. So if you do those first, then you're kind of pre-exhausted before you do the pushing exercises. Okay, 14 seconds. Let's get ready here for our next set of flies. I don't know about you, but I'm sweating already. Let me start the timer here. We've done our two sets of flies. You notice the on the first set I did 7 reps at 105. This time I did, you know, 3 good ones, maybe 4. So you can tell I'm already starting to get a little fatigued. In any case, now we're moving on to dumbbell press. I would suggest using the same weight that you just did on flies. Or, you know, if you think you can, go up. You intermediates and advanced, we're aiming for, you know, 3 to 7 reps here. If you're a beginner, we're aiming for probably 12 to 20 reps. So let me answer, I have 2 minutes, let me answer some questions from YouTube here. Where's your dog? Get the dog. He kind of gets in the way. I don't want to, when I'm doing heavy weights, I get a little worried that I'm going to crush him with the weight. So he's outside. Next question. Why do you bend your elbows during the flies? Very good question. This is a leverage thing. So when you're doing flies, if you do, optimal is, this is not, you don't want your elbows locked. That's bad. Bent about like that is good. Relieves a little strain on the elbow. However, you can take this to the ridiculous extreme. What you see a lot of people do, they'll hold the dumbbells like this and do this motion. Because of leverage, you can probably, if you're holding the weights in like this, you can do about 4 times as much weight. You're only fooling yourself. The further they are out, the more difficult it is. As long as you realize this, you're fine. It's okay to be educated about cheating. So a lot of times what I'll do, when I start, my arms are, you know, almost locked. As I get toward the end of what I can do, I'll bend my arms a little more, and it's the same effect of having a spotter. It lets you do more reps by decreasing the load a little bit. So anyway, that's about the elbows. Let's see. If you bend your elbows, you're not doing flies. Yeah, well, if you bend them this much, yeah, you're not doing anything because you don't have any range of motion. Scooby, how much do you weigh? That is a good question. My scale's not out. I haven't weighed myself for a while, but probably 235. I hover there, plus or minus a couple pounds. So sorry, I'd love to take more questions. Next set. Okay, so now we're doing dumbbell press. Now we're going to do the same thing with our shoulders that we talked about before. Shoulders are down and back. Hold them like that, the whole set. Start the timer, we get 3 minutes rest, and I'll answer some more questions here. Why do you only do 3 reps? Because you'll find out later in the workout. I love this workout because what we're gonna do, it's a great mix of heavyweight, lightweight, and high rep, low rep. Right now we're doing heavy. We're starting out heavy, and then we're gonna go to lighter weights with higher reps. So I'm not trying for any specific number now. Once I choose a weight, I just do as many reps as I can. Again, if you're a beginner, you should be aiming much higher in reps than that, 12 to 20, because you don't wanna get injured. Okay, let's see. Are you still doing flies? No, we're on dumbbell press now. We're gonna do one more set of dumbbell press, then we have a special surprise for you. I'm not gonna tell you what we're gonna do after that. Scooby, you're awesome, thank you. That's from Christian24. Here's a good question. Have you ever injured yourself in doing workouts? I can proudly say that in 30 years of lifting, I have never, ever, ever been injured in a weight room. I've been injured a zillion times in sports outside of the gym, but, you know, as they say in Germany, Sport macht Mord, meaning sport is murder. I've sprained my ankle playing volleyball, I've dislocated my shoulder playing water polo, I've messed up my knee running. I could go on and on, but have I ever been injured in the weight room? No, because I use slow, but have I ever been injured in the weight room? No. If you get injured, you get set back 6 months or a year, so it's really worth using good form to make sure you don't get injured. I do many other leg exercises, but not squatting. Okay, we're going to go ahead and do our second set of dumbbell press and reps. You beginners aim for like 12 to 20 reps. Again, I know I emphasize this till I'm blue in the face, but down and back. Oops, did we lose picture? Hold on, something's screwy here. Just making sure we got picture still. Okay, I think we're back. Just making sure we had a picture there. Okay, this is our second set of dumbbell press. Going to do a superset of flies and dumbbell press. So what we're going to do, we're going to drop the weight to about 80% of what we were just doing. So let's go ahead and get that ready. I love doing this next exercise, the supersets. one problem with home workouts, good and bad, you spend a lot of time swapping weights around, which is why I organize the workouts the way I do. When we do these supersets, you'll notice that we're going to do the flies first. That's because for 99% of the people on the planet, they're much stronger in the dumbbell press than they are in the flies. So by doing the dumbbell press second in the superset, you're pre-exhausted from doing the flies, so it evens it out. It works out really well. Now, if you're not sweating now, your room's not as warm as mine is. Okay, I have time to answer one quick question, and then we're going to go ahead and start our superset. Actually, let me quick show you what we're going to do here. So, beginners, here's what we're going to do. We're going to do a set of flies, as many as we can do, and then we're going to go directly into the press and do as many as we can. That's all a superset means. Okay, time for one quick question. People, refresh your page. If you ever notice the image stop, just refresh your page. I don't know if that's my DSL or what the deal is, but if it's YouTube, but if the image ever goes away, just refresh your page. Okay, someone asked that already. How much do I weigh? About 235. Where is Hans? Good question. That is a good question. Let me show you where Hans is. He's up above the aquarium. Let me bring him down. We'll bring down Hans and Klaus. I hope I don't smash them with the waves. Okay, time for our superset. Again, remember, the whole set, we're keeping our shoulders down and back. Thrust your chest out. Okay, here we go. Okay, I got one more knee then. Okay, dumbbell press. I'm starting to burn. Okay, I didn't keep track there. That was maybe 7 or 8. Okay, I'm going to start the timer. We get 3 minutes rest. And then we're going to do another superset. Flies and dumbbell press. For those of you that joined, tuned in late, let me just invite you again to tomorrow's workout. It starts at the same time, and we're going to do a back workout. You do need a pull-up bar for this. There's no other way. If you don't have a pull-up bar, go out to your big box store and buy a doorway mount. They work fine. You can do this workout with that. Excuse me, let's answer some YouTube questions. Someone asked, so what's the deal with this scar right here? That's not a stretch mark. Back when I was 28, I had a dislocated shoulder from inner tube water polo. And they had to do open surgery here. I have some staples in there that tighten up the shoulder so it wouldn't dislocate again. Good eye. I'm surprised you could actually see that on this, this streaming broadcast, because it's only 640 by 360. Scooby, are you a giant? I'm 6'3". I don't think that qualifies as being a giant. Let's see. Romanian fan here. Hey, I'm glad this does work in Europe. So welcome to all of Europe who's joining me here. Let's see, do we have time for another question? Okay, nope, sorry. More questions in a bit. We're going to do our next superset. Okay, once again, we're going to do dumbbell flies, as many as you can do, and then dumbbell press, as many as you can do. Shoulders down and back. Okay, I'm in trouble. If I can only do four there, I need to drop and wait next time. Okay, press. Epic fail. Okay, I have to drop and wait. I only did four on the flies and two on the press. I need to do more reps than that, so I'm going to lower the weight here. Hopefully you're better at adjusting the weight. Now, during this workout, feel free to keep dropping the weights to keep your number of reps in the right range. Which still for you intermediate advanced is 3 to 7 reps. For you beginners, 12 to 20 reps. Okay, we're going to do another set of, just like we did, the supersets of flies and press in 3 minutes, but I'm going to answer some questions. As soon as I clean up my room. Okay, I'm back. Let's see. Put Hans on the blue chair. That's funny. How'd my chair get? Okay, we'll put Hans on there. That's a good idea. Great idea. I don't know who suggested that, but. Okay, I'm waiting for it to stop scrolling so I can answer a question here. Why does it say you have been streaming for 4 hours? That's a good question. I started half an hour early just to make sure it was working, but I actually didn't start the workout till 10 a.m. Brazil, hey, welcome Brazil. Someone asked if I'm married. Yes, I'm married. I've been married 10 years. If you want to find out more about me and all my hobbies and stuff, go to scoobiesworkshop.com and check on the About Me section. All more than you ever wanted to know, I promise. Okay, we still have 1 minute. Time for one more question. Scooby, are you aware? Am I aware of what? Greetings from Serbia. Wow, I'm glad the international stuff is working. Thanks to YouTube for providing this streaming. I actually tried this on Ustream last year and it was a dismal failure. It didn't work at all. So I am so excited that this is actually working now. Okay, we're going to do another superset. Let's go ahead and get ready. Remember, we're doing dumbbell flies followed by dumbbell press. I dropped in weight. I should be able to do better. Ignore that sound. Part of working out is being able to ignore all external distractions. This is a perfect example. Just keep working out. Do as many flies as you can. Now, if the building's burning down, you have permission to stop your set. But unless your life's in danger, ignore the distraction. Okay. How we doing for time here? We are going to do another superset, just like that, in 3 minutes. Let's answer some more questions, though. Okay. Saudi Arabia. Wow. I'm so excited. Mexico. I am so grateful you people have tuned in. I was worried everyone was going to be pissed off at me for blowing the broadcast last weekend and wasting everyone's time. So thank you very much for giving me a second chance. This is quite exciting. Iceland. Okay, this is too cool. Let's go for some real questions here. How often do you wash your carpet? It's never been washed. As a matter of fact, I sweat so much that I smell like a sheep when I'm done. I think this is wool. Got it used. As a matter of fact, we didn't even wash it when we got it used. So I don't know that. I don't know what's been on this carpet, but I smell like a wet sheep right now. Okay. No more questions. What should I talk about? One thing, there's a lot of disagreement about going to failure. There's pros and cons. You'll notice I go to failure every time, but that's not widely agreed upon. It's definitely mixed. But bodybuilding is as much art as science. You gotta be careful about research. It's good to know what the research says, but you gotta experiment and see what works for you. Okay, time is almost up. We're gonna do another set. Now remember, don't feel bad about dropping in weight. This is a pretty intense workout, and you're gonna have to drop your weight, your sets and range. As a matter of fact, I should probably drop now, but I'm not, because it's too late. I'm probably only going to be able to do three reps on the flies and maybe four on the press. I should have dropped. But I'll drop this time. Okay. What do we do? Shoulders down and back. Thrust that chest out. Okay, start the timer. We are only going to do one more set of those, and then we're moving on to our next exercise. One thing you'll notice, so far you're probably thinking, my gosh, all he's done is flies and press. Well, you don't necessarily need to do a complicated workout to have a good workout. It's good to mix things up. You know, maybe one workout, you do 10 different exercises with one set of each. Just do one exercise, but do it for your entire workout. It's really good to mix things up like that. A lot of times when I'm traveling, what I'll do, the week before I travel, I'll maybe do lots of different exercises. For a long push-up workout, I'll do wide push-ups, I'll do hip push-ups, I'll do all kinds of push-ups. Now, it's a great way to mix it up, and you can get an amazing workout just doing one exercise. Remember, by the way, if your picture stops, refresh your browser. Now let's talk about what we're going to do next. You need to get a... Oh, wait, no, sorry, we're doing one more set of those first. After that, we're going to do incline flies and push-ups. That's where we get lightweight, high rep. So be thinking about getting your light weights ready. I actually use, 15-pound dumbbells for these incline flies. How are we doing for time? I think I have time for some questions. Scooby, do you have kids? Again, everything you want to know about me is on the About Me page on scoobiesworkshop.com. I do not have kids. I do have a number of wonderful pets. Our dog Milo, our turtle Sammy, our pet Skunk, who's adopted us out under our shed in the item shelter. He's completely wild. And then all our fish. Scooby, are dried banana chips healthy? The problem with those is they have a lot of oil. I've never seen dried banana chips that were did not have a lot of oil in them. Fresh bananas are much better. If you could find dried banana chips that don't have oil added, I'd be all for it. But I think the problem is they turn funny colors and look gross if you don't put the oil on them. Okay, time for our last superset before we try our next exercise. Okay, let's do it. Wonder why I wear a hat even inside. I use it as a sweatband. You probably can't see this, but it's almost completely soaked in sweat. I hate the sweat running down my face. Ugh. Besides, I love hats. Okay, I admit it. Shoulders down and back. Let's make this good. This is our last heavy set. Get all this stuff out of the way, and let me show you what we're going to do next. Okay, most of us don't have incline benches because we work out at home. This is easy. This is a really lightweight. We're going to lean against the wall so that our torso is about at a 45 degree angle, and we're going to do incline flies like this. And we're going to keep our thumbs up when we do this. Not out to the side, not down, thumbs up. So out wide to up high. So go ahead and get a lightweight setup. As I say, I'm pretty strong on flies and I'm only doing, 15 pounds. So it's a lot harder than it looks. We're going to do a superset again. We're going to do incline flies, and then we're going to go to push-ups. If you're a beginner, I want you to do a knee push-up like this. And you advanced people or intermediate, we're going to do a normal push-up. By this time, you're pretty exhausted. You're going to find that doing those push-ups is going to be murder. Normally push-ups are easy if you do them fresh, but by this time it's going to be tough. Even you intermediates and advanced might find you're going to need to do knee push-ups. Where's my timer? We still have a minute here to answer some questions. Let's see. Put cushion back for your lower back. I'm not sure what that's referring to. Okay, another question as soon as it stops scrolling here. Do you do triceps with your chest workout? Well, that's a very good question. Anytime you're doing a pushing exercise, like a bench press or a dumbbell press, when your elbow is extending, you're doing triceps. So anytime you're doing a pressing exercise, you're working out triceps. Whereas with a squeezing exercise like flies, you're not doing any triceps at all. It's an isolation exercise. It just does pecs. So that's why, that's a good question. Do you do work out your triceps when you're going to do pecs? If you're going to combine two workouts, that's an excellent combination to do. Start with a pushing exercise and then do triceps. That's why a lot of people divide their workouts into push workouts and pull workouts. I think what I like to see advanced people do is do one body part per day. So, for example, I will not do tricep with chest. Anyway, enough yammering. Let's get going here. So, I'm going to do our incline flies. So, lean against the wall. Feet up. Keeps you from sliding. Thumbs up and up. I'm being very careful because this is a glass aquarium behind me. Actually, no, it's plexiglass. In any case, I do not want the dumbbells going through the aquarium. Again, shoulders down and back. Every exercise we do is shoulders down and back. Okay, no rest. Directly into the push-up. Beginners do knee push-ups. Everyone else, normal push-ups. That was pretty pathetic, wasn't it? I only did like 8 reps. Again, we're completely exhausted by this point. Now we're into the higher rep, lower weight phase of our workout. We're only going to do 2 minutes between sets here. Let me just take a minute. We haven't talked about the push-up for the beginners out there. Let's talk about form of the push-up. I like to see people do this on their fist. The problem is when you do your palm like this, some of you have good wrist flexibility. I don't. That's about as far as my wrists go. If your wrist goes down like that, if you can bend it backwards, then you're okay to do push-ups on your palms. But if your wrist only does that, it's really hard on your wrist to do push-ups on your palms. I would rather see you do them on your fists. That's what the fit, it's much stronger when the weight is aligned wrist forearm. That is where the strongest portion is. So do it from your fist. Use pillows if you need to. Don't bother your fist. Again, this is not good. This is not good. Straight and very slow. Your head is not bobbing. Okay, do I have time for a question? One quick question, then we go back to our next set. Okay, are you German? No, I'm actually Dutch. I'm 3/4 Dutch. But Dutch was not taught in my school. It's not a very common language in America. So I learned German, the next best thing. And I actually lived in Germany for 2 years. Where I worked and had to speak German in the office. So, although I'm Dutch, I think I have more of an affinity to Germany because I live there. I love the Netherlands. I've spent a number of vacations there cycling, but I don't speak the language. Okay, let's do our next set. Okay, lean against the wall, 45 degrees, knees bent, feet up flat on the floor to keep you from sliding down, shoulders down and back. Do not break the aquarium behind you. I was traumatized by that
YouTube clip of the kid running the barbell through his aquarium and all the fish flopping on the floor. My angel fish would not be happy. Do as many as you can. Remember, this is the high rep portion. If you're only doing like 8 reps, you need to lower the weight. Okay. Now do as many push-ups as you can. Don't be ashamed to do knee push-ups here if you need to. Knee push-ups and do some more. I only did 8. I want this to be higher rep. Okay, 2 minutes rest and we'll do it again. Let me answer some questions. Again, I want to remind you, please join me tomorrow for my back workout. It starts at the same time. Get yourself a pull-up bar at any of your big box sporting goods stores, or actually any of the big box merchandisers have them too. A doorway mount pull-up bar. They're like $20. Questions? Isn't a fly more of a shoulder exercise? No, it is pecs. It does use some shoulders, but predominantly pecs. So my question, is Scooby married? Yes, I'm married. Please check the About Me section on my website. I've been married 10 years. Just had our anniversary a couple months ago. Protein drinks for teens. That's an interesting question. Let's talk about that. First of all, I consider protein powder a food and not a supplement. It's processed milk. It's a food. Milk is a food. When you get the protein powders, what they're doing is taking out the sugars. So isolated whey takes out the sugars in the milk, leaving you with just the protein. I do not believe in any of the pre-made protein shakes, weight gainers. If you want a protein shake, make your own. They're cheaper and healthier, far healthier. There's a recipe on my website. Use any protein powder you want, but make sure it's just protein powder, nothing else in it. No supplements, no creatine, no nothing. Just get simple, good protein powder. And you can make an awesome protein drink. There's nothing magical about protein. This is important, I'll continue. There is nothing magical about protein shakes. It's just a meal replacement. They will not make your muscles grow. And as a matter of fact, people sometimes think that they can just have a protein shake and get muscles without working out. Not gonna happen. Okay, let's do another set here. Lean against the wall, 45 degree angle, feet on the floor, shoulders down and back. Thumbs up and go. My poor fish, I'm sure, is nervous. Drop to knee push-ups if you need to, or start with them if you can't do more than 8. So. Oh, God, I'm tired. Okay, let's talk about something really important. I'm sure a lot of you are making fun of me for all my grunting and groaning. Forceful exhalation actually has a very important purpose in lifting. There's a reason that martial artists, when they punch, go, ha! It tightens the core, it gives you additional power. Now, if you're in a gym, be considerate. Don't be yelling at the top of your lungs when you're doing your 5-pound flies. You're going to get yourself thrown out of the gym. However, when you're working out at home, don't worry what the neighbors think. When you start worrying about what other people think about your workout, that's when you start to have horrible workouts and not get progress. Don't worry about what other people think. Don't worry about how, if you think you're doing enough weight, just do the weight you can control with good form. That is the important thing. And with the, don't worry, you know, if you're grunting and groaning, so what? Let him get over it. Let's answer a few questions here. Strong boobs. Okay, yeah, I have pretty good pecs, considering I'm over 50. Let's see. My comments are screwed up here. I'm waiting for them to refresh. Okay, here's another set of comments. What do you think about hydroxy cut? Very good question. They are the number one weight loss product, and they actually came near, killed a bunch of people a few years back. They had toxins in it or something. Their product was pulled off the market because I think like 30 people had liver damage and one person died from toxic impurities in their product. Do a Google search on hydroxycut recall and then ask yourself, do you want to be taking something that's completely untested and could kill you on occasion? You know, they're one of the biggest, most respected weight loss companies out there. And if they can't get it right, what about these small companies? You know, I'm a strong believer that supplements should be regulated at least for toxicity testing. Anyway, I don't suggest you use supplements for that reason, but you know, get off my soapbox. A lot of you use supplements. Just remember, these are not tested in any sort of way. Don't think that the government is out there testing these to make sure they're safe, because they're not. Okay, shoulders down and back, feet on the floor. Make all the noise you want. Okay, do push-ups. I'm going to do as many as I can and then drop to a knee push-up. Okay, we're almost at the end of our time slot here. We're going to do one more set of those. Again, I want to thank you for joining me and giving me a second chance after I screwed up so bad last week. And again, please remember, if you would like, join me at the same time tomorrow for doing a back workout. Get yourself a pull-up bar. We won't interfere with the Super Bowl. So those of you that are going to watch the Super Bowl later in the day, that's awesome. Do a workout with me, have a tough workout, and then have a cheat meal when you're watching the Super Bowl to compensate for the hard workout you did in the morning. Okay, let me answer a few more questions and we'll do our last set and call it a day. Give us your opinion on the Hodge twins. Well, honestly, I have not seen any of their videos, so I can't say anything. What is the best cardio? Great question. It depends on what your goals are. people always ask, you know, what is the best workout? What is the best cardio? It depends on what your goals are. The best cardio for a 18-year-old track star is going to be completely different than the best cardio workout for a 35-year-old who's overweight. There's a number of things you need to, it's like, are you trying to run faster? Are you just trying to burn off as many calories as possible? Or, you know, are you trying to build up your endurance for doing long distance events? So let me answer for me. I'm doing a half Ironman in this spring. So for me, the best cardio is endurance, because you got to train for what you're going to do. And, you know, I'm going to be running a half marathon, biking a zillion miles, and, Okay, let's do our last set, and then we'll call it a day. Lean against the wall, feet flat on the floor, shoulders down and back, thumbs up. Okay, push-ups. Do as many as you can, then drop to knees. I don't know about you, but I have a great chest pump, and I'm dead. Okay, that is it. Thank you very much for joining me. Remember, tune in same time tomorrow, and we'll do a back workout. Go ahead and get that pull-up bar. I'm going to sign off here. I'll be answering a few questions on Facebook for the next 15 minutes, so if you've got questions, ask me there. Thank you much. Auf Wiedersehen. Ugh.